Okay, today we are looking at ways to suggest light and shadow in our painting. And I'm talking specifically about using photographs, but also painting outside. I try and do these things to help me to see the difference between the dark and the light and to kind of push those differences to create more effect of light and shadow. And first thing here is there's four keys to kind of remember to think about as you're painting. Number one, I think, and the most important, is to simplify your subject, the big shapes. Eliminate detail, because we're so used to focusing, or we're geared towards looking at the detail, not the big shape. So get in the habit of finding those big dark and light shapes. Number two is push the value contrast between the big dark and light shapes. The more you can separate the difference between dark and light, create more contrast, you get more suggestion of light. And number three is pushing color temperature contrast. The warm and cool colors, the more I can separate the temperature differences, the more I'm gonna suggest sunlight. And last is create more saturated color in the foreground compared to the background. So as things move forward, come up front, I'm gonna have a bit stronger color compared to the background. It's not that the foreground colors are all just real bright. They don't have to be extremely bright, but compared to the background, they need to be at least a bit more saturated. So first image here, and I got some photographs and some paintings here I'm comparing. And we'll kind of look at the differences or some of the things I did to push the light and shadow a bit more. This is a scene in Arizona. And here the contrast is pretty good, the value contrast. There's good dark and light shapes in the background, in the hills, and also in the foreground. That strong dark foreground against the lighter middle ground and background really suggests sunlight, but color-wise, the shadows are a bit on the dead side. So the colors in here don't have any temperature to them to suggest shadow. So in my painting here, I push the path, the shrubbery. I wanted to separate it from the green quite a bit, plus make it cool. So I made it more of a violet. That's a bit more on the red violet. Didn't have to go reddish violet. I could have gone just more blue violet or muted violet, but chose the red violet. And that separates that cooler color, the violets and the blue greens on the greenery here, really separates from the warmth of the middle ground and background. So pushing that temperature there. Same thing with the middle ground mountain back in here. I didn't push the lights lighter, but I did push the shadows bluer. In other words, I increased the suggestion of cool color against the warmer yellow green of the hills. And that contrast of really cool against the really warm makes the sunlight and shadow aspect really pop a lot more. So pushing those value changes. Also, colors can also get a lot more muted, grayed, or kind of chalky in the background. I do want the colors more muted and cooler as I go back, but not that much. So I increase the color saturation there. It is cool, but not quite as white as the photograph. Photograph, again, gets kind of washed out. So pushing the color temperature here in the shadows is the key. Next one here, it's a scene in southern Utah, and it's a sunlit day. You got a strip of sunlight back in here, and you got shadow here, but it's kind of an overall hazy day. But I can go with the idea that it is sunlight and push that a bit more by, first of all, increasing the sunlight in the background. That little strip of kind of hazy sunlight in the background, I can push that warmer, create little shapes in the trees that give the trees some more shape and some variation. And then also push the foreground cooler, using more blue greens, blues, violets in the foreground and not so much of the greens and grayer and darker greens. Just think more about temperature change. Also a little bit about value change. I'm making the foreground a bit darker than it is in the photograph. So just pushing contrast and temperature here, as well as, especially in the background, the intensity of that color to really look more sunlit. And this is one of those things where the background color is the most intense. With the rule, the idea that everything being equal, the foreground colors are going to be a lot stronger. Here it's different because the foreground's in shadow. It's going to be cooler, not as strong as the sunlit background area. So rules are made to be broken. And this is in Tennessee. And I'm doing a couple of things here. The photograph on the left has good dark shadows or good darks as far as value goes, but there's not much color in those darks, not much temperature. So you can see the shadows here. I created more of a definite shadow pattern first, starting with the tree. The tree has dark and light, but I separated the dark and light more. I created a definite pattern or shape for the shadow and the light, whereas in the photograph, it's not that definite. It just really helps to design the shape of the tree to make it read more like sunlight and shadow. So I think I improved that compared to the photo, plus the definite shadow pattern on the smaller trees here, created a little bit more shadow pattern here on the right side of the painting. So just pushing more definite separation between dark and light, especially in the trees and the shrubbery, and then pushing the temperature here in the foreground and in the trees, pushing temperature in the shadows more blue greens, violets. And that doesn't mean you can't have orange in the shadow. When I say pushing the temperature, making the shadows cooler to show lack of sunlight, you want to do that, but that doesn't mean you can't have a warm color in the shadow. The key is that warmer color just has to be cooler than the sunlit color. So I have a sunlit orange that's warmer, more yellow, and then a muted, darker, a little bit cooler orange that has a little bit of violet in it. I'm still using the local color of orange, but pushing the temperature difference between the sunlight and shadow. Of course, I added the barn and all that stuff. Also emphasized this shadow here, made it a lot cooler, and designed it a bit more than what's in the photograph. Pushing the temperature in the background, the shadows in the background hill, also pushing the hills a lot cooler, makes them recede back a lot farther as well. This is in Wyoming, near Sheridan, and a nice sunny day. You got strong darks in here, strong sunlight. Problem is, the greens here are pretty much all the same. In other words, I got same green here, as I do in the foreground. So there's no depth there, there's no variation. There is some yellow green in the sunlit greens, but a lot of it's just green, which doesn't really have any temperature. When you have the color green and you're trying to make it look sunlit, like grass or trees, you have to push it more towards the yellow green to make it look sunlit. Same thing in the shadow, you push it more towards bluish green. And again, this is just a dark green, this is just a light green. So I want to think more in terms of temperature there. So what I did using Photoshop here, I made these greens more of a blue green, but they're light enough that they look sunlit, but the bluish green there really makes them recede and stay back into the background. Then a little bit more yellow green using a lot of yellow ochre, orange, cad yellow and blue for the green. Comes forward a bit more because it's warmer. And then in the front here, I've added a little lighter, but more saturated yellow green to make it come forward. And a lot of cool color variation in the shadow. So I went a bit more blue green in the shadow than the photograph shows. Also pushed a lot more little color variation in the creek. A lot cooler, a little cooler back in here. Cooler trees in the background just to make them again recede and go back. Also, more separation of dark and light within the foliage. So picking up some of this dappled light that I feel in the photograph I'm pushing that a lot more. Sharper edges, more contrast between the dark and light. So less halftone, less subtlety between the values and making it more definite. The more it's a cloudy day, the more I'm gonna have halftone. When it's a bright sunny day like this, I'm gonna have less halftone and stronger separation of dark and light. So next one here is, this is a place in Greece I was at. And it's a bit of a hazy day. You can see the sky's kind of cloudy. And you can see the wall here is half shadow, half sunlight. The shadow pattern on the trees isn't as distinct, doesn't jump out as much. So when I paint this, I want to push all that. So here's my solutions. Making the sky bluer to suggest brighter, sunnier day. A couple of different values of blue. But if you look at the foliage that overhangs the sidewalk, I'm just separating the dark and light a lot stronger. I've got two or three different values, but the lights and darks are really separate. And I can have some variation of value in there, not just one light, one dark, but the separation of dark and light is a lot stronger than that. So really pushing it. Also the wall, I'm making the decision that the wall is going to be in shadow and that's going to be in sunlight. So I created the shadow, cast shadow on the wall down here, and which, you know, doesn't have in the photograph, but I'm pushing the sun back just a bit to create all shadow and a little bit of cast shadow there. And creating more contrast between the cast shadow on the ground in front and the sunlight here. And I'm doing that by just increasing the sunlight on the sidewalk. It's not bright enough, so pushing that. And then making the shadow a little cooler, a little more on the bluish side of gray than just a gray. So sometimes gray value is working, but I need that cooler temperature within that gray value to make it look more sunlit. And just increasing some of the shadows contrast-wise to create more sense of sunlight. Now this is in Chewback, Arizona. And sunny day, it's got a lot of brightness here, but I want to increase the temperature. Temperature in the lights here. The lights get a little washed out on the wall. In other words, too much white. When we add too much white to our lights, that makes them cooler, for one thing, and it decreases the intensity. White will mute your color. So I want to do two things. I want to cool off the shadows, and I want to warm up the light area, making the lights a bit more saturated. Still a real light orange, but not quite as light as the photograph caught it. And then creating more violets within the dark orange. Cast shadow in the photograph is a definite dark orange, but not necessarily a cool temperature compared to the sunlight. So dragging in some violets on top of that dark orange, and, you know, thinking in terms of paint, the dark, if I block it in a dark orange, orange and a little blue and maybe some crimson, I'm gonna come back and add some violet to it to make it even cooler than what I see. So it gets that temperature contrast as well as value contrast. Also simplifying the trees. Again, that strong separation of sunlight and shadow. I don't want this as much, which is the shadows aren't quite dark enough. Lights aren't quite light enough, so going in and really creating more contrast in there to suggest that real strong light. Here's another one in Colorado. Old photograph, so colors aren't very strong, not much temperature change there. But also, you can see there's sunlight on the grass here, and it's kind of a hazy day, really cold. Couldn't paint, I could just photograph. But I want to create more separation of dark and light in the foreground and get more of a sense of sunlight and shadow on the trees and the rocks. And it's not there in the photograph, so I'm going to have to create that. And this is what I did. You can see really created more separation there of sunlight and shadow in the foreground. Making it up, yes, but I'm still trying to suggest what the photograph is trying to show us here, and that's a little bit of sunlight hitting in here on top of the grass, but by just making it darker in the shadow and cooler and lighter and warmer in the sunlight, that really helps. Plus adding subtle kind of rim lighting in the trees and on the rock of just the light, the sun being in front of us over to the right and just hitting the edges of the trees and the rocks. So that goes a long way just to creating more sunlight. Also simplifying the tree here. The tree in the photograph, very sparse. So a lot of little dots and dashes. I want to either create more empty space of sky in there or fill in the tree a bit more. And I went ahead and filled in the tree a bit more. This last one here, this is in Sedona, and this has a lot of sunlight in it. Again, I would want more contrast between the dark and the light. Dark and light in these trees here. Some of the shadows just get too light, and some of the lights just aren't light enough to create that contrast. Good separation of value in the rocks, but I want to downplay some of this detail to create bigger shapes of dark and light, which again suggests the type of time of day it is, the strong sunlight, and not so much geared towards showing all the detail on the cliffs. So here are my changes. Simplified that area in there, made the shadows in the cliffs a little darker, a little cooler, and more simplified. Again, getting rid of a lot of that detail. Not that I can't have more detail than this, I can, but I at least want to start here before I start adding more detail. And still being selective, I don't want to overdo it, but really separating the dark and the light more, plus in the trees, creating bigger dark shapes, bigger light shapes, and more separation between them value-wise. Too many middle values in these shadows here, so making a definite stronger shadow pattern that stands up along with the lighter shape in there. So you can see it really simplifies the trees and it makes them look more sunlit. Now my edges are real hard. I can soften edges with the paint, obviously, when I'm putting them in, and also the foreground, simplifying that foreground a bit more to create a stronger sense of sunlight and shadow. So I think, again, probably the major thing to look for is how to simplify, how to get rid of detail, pull those shapes together to create bigger dark and light shapes, then work on the intensity, the value, and the temperature of those shapes. So I hope that was helpful. Click the like if it was, and if you want to see another video on suggesting light, watch this next one called Using Color Temperature to Suggest Light.